Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I thought I would show you what is in our family medical box and our travel medical kit as well. The other day I was organizing these, just looking through them and checking expiry dates on medicine, and I thought that this might make an interesting video, so I hope you really enjoy it. First things first, I am not a doctor or a medical professional at all, but I am a mum to three boys who have had various ailments and illnesses over the years, and I've definitely built these up over time. And of course, what I have in my family medical kit will be different to what you have, but it might just give you a few ideas. One thing I really do like and would totally recommend is having the majority of your medical supplies in one place. I bought this tin off of a website called Cox & Cox. I got it years ago. If it's still available, I'll link it down below. I just really like the way it looked, and it's quite a good size to hold a lot of things. But even if you just had an old basket and you kept everything together, it's just handy, especially if you have a babysitter looking after your children. They know exactly where to go. Everything is in one place. Whereas before I had this, it was all scattered around the house. I had like some pills upstairs. I had some medicine downstairs, some in the baby's room. And it would have been quite confusing if anyone else was looking after our children. So I really like having this all in one place. We keep it downstairs. So I'll just go through and show you what we've got. So if you open up our medical kit, there is a top section here with three different compartments, one for pills, one for plasters and band-aids, and this is quite miscellaneous. This section actually comes out and reveals lots more medicine at the bottom, but I'll just show you what's on the top bit for now. This one is all for band-aids and plasters. There's also a little prompt in these sections as well. And we have pretty much every shape and size, mostly Star Wars, Mickey Mouse stuff, Paw Patrol. And we really do go through these from all the grazes, you know, cut fingers, blisters, everything. We do use plasters a lot. In this section, it's a bit random, but I wanted to show you that we've got this wound spray, which is really good. It's alcohol-free, so it doesn't sting the kids. And obviously it's so important to wash their cuts as soon as they happen. So we use that for that. I've also got a little cream for stings and for bites, because like every now and then they will get stung by a wasp or a bee or whatever. So it's handy to have that. And if we go out for a day, it's worth taking this. They'll probably always get bitten when I don't have this on me. But we have that just in case. Then I've always had sterile gauze on me just in case they cut themselves. It's good to have this, but they never have, so I guess that's fortunate, but I have it in case they hurt themselves. And then I've also got more gauze and bandages as well here. I also have a medical tape. We have a digital thermometer to check people's temperatures. We have an antiseptic cream. This is perfect for grazes and cuts, so I would wash it, put some of this on, then put a bandage on. Then this one's a bit random, but I have really loved having this little cream. It's called Emla cream, and it's a numbing cream. So if the kids ever have injections, I would put this onto their arm or leg, wherever it's going to be, and this will numb the area. It really does help, but you have to put it on a full half an hour before they have their injections. So it's whether you remember to do it, but it really does work. So I've loved having that. We've also got bazooka for verrucas, because the boys got one from their swimming lessons. Verrucas in Canada, I think they're called planter's warts. They're horrible, horrible things. We've also got cold sore cream. Then this section here is mainly for pills. At the top, I have the boys' Calpol, which is paracetamol. But these little tablets are so great. They melt in the kids' mouths. They can only have it if they're 6 years and up. So this is really for my two older boys. But they're great for travel because they're not liquid. You can pack them easily. And the boys much prefer having these to the liquid, especially if they feel really ill. They don't always want the really sweet syrup. So I would totally recommend them for older kids. Then we've also got just paracetamol for me and Matt. And just random like hay fever bits. Things to give the kids liquid medicine as well. Then moving on to the bottom section where we keep like bigger boxes of medicine, I'll just talk you through what's in here. So in this section, we have various boxes of pills, like cold and flu, a bit more paracetamol. We have Sudafed because Matt does suffer with his sinuses. We've got a nasal spray. And then this one, mums of school age children might know this one. This one is called Ovex and it is a threadworm treatment. I always have this in stock because every now and then when your kids are at school, we'll get a text saying, there is a case of threadworms in the class. And then I kind of wait to see if any of the kids get symptoms. And then if they do, this is a medicine that the entire family can just all do a shot of. And then it kind of like clears it. And then I have another one because you're supposed to do that 1 week. And then after a week, do a shot again. It's really simple, but I like to have it in because it lasts quite a long time. This doesn't go off until 2022. We also sometimes get texts like when your kids are school age about head lice. But luckily, my kids have actually never got that. Because I have all boys and they have very short hair, they have never seemed to actually pick it up even when it's at school. So that's good. We've also got lots of allergy tablets. Matt really suffers with hay fever. We've also got a hydrocortisone cream. So one of my sons gets eczema and every now and then it gets a bit bad if he's been swimming a lot or it's very hot. And so this really does help. So you can just get this over the counter or you can be prescribed it as well. We've also got a box of Dyrolite sachets, which is an electrolyte powder. So it basically replaces your body salts. So if you had a horrible sickness bug, or diarrhea, or you've actually been out drinking for a very long time, this would really hydrate you. So these are great to have. So you just mix a sachet of powder in the water, or I also like to sometimes make ice lollies or popsicles with them in it, because if the boys are really ill and they don't even want to drink water, that helps. Or a hack that I do is with a little like medical syringe, I would make up a sachet and then give them just 5 mil or a syringe of this every 5 minutes or so. And then over the course of an hour, they actually drink down quite a lot. So that's a really good hack and works well if my boys ever have a sickness bug. Luckily, we don't get sick very often. And the one positive of being in lockdown and staying in is like no one's been unwell for so long in our house. But I've also got these little nasal drops or nasal spray for the kids. It's literally just saline drops, which are just great because if the kids ever do get a stuffed up nose, it's normally in the middle of the night, so I always like to have it in. Then I've also got a dry cough and throat syrup. I've got Nurofen and Calpol for the little one because obviously he can't take those Calpol tablets. And then we've also got a bottle of liquid Piriton, which is for allergies. One of my children has an allergy and in the first instance, you give them Piriton. We've also got a triangular bandage, which is basically a sling. We've never needed it. I've had it for years. But when I was looking up what to keep in a medical box, this came up on every single list. So I got one, but touch wood, we've never actually needed it. Then I've also got a few little sachets of Calpol or paracetamol, which are perfect for travel and taking out with us in my handbag. So I could grab these. Then I've also got quite a few sachets of Alka-Seltzer, which is like an aspirin, but to be honest, we use this more for science experiments than anything else. I also have a little barrier cream. All my kids are out of nappies. I used to have barrier cream in like every single room, but now I just have one in case anyone needs it. And then the last thing is I have these little deep freeze patches. So you get 4 patches in a pack like this. And this is mainly for my eldest who plays football a lot. If he ever hurts a muscle or sprains himself during sports or anything, you can just stick a patch onto them rather than holding ice on them the whole time. Obviously, ice is fine and we have that. We've also got frozen peas for bumped heads and things. But these patches are quite handy if he really does hurt a muscle. I can just stick one of these onto him, and when I hurt my foot, these worked well as well. And then for travel or when we go away, I like to use a clear makeup bag. I got 3 of these from Primark as a set. They were really cheap and I always use them when we go away. So I'm using the smallest one for our medicine, and it's pretty much just all of that in a smaller version, but I'll quickly show you what's in this. So we have plasters, we have another Verruca medicine, we've got Nurofen for the little one, hay fever tablets, allergy tablets, another digital thermometer, scissors. Then I have a smaller little like alcohol-free wipes if the kids cut themselves. We can use that with the plasters. I've also got some Imodium because if you were ever on a plane, you might want those. And I've got the little sachets of Diverlite, little sachets of Calpol for travel. I've got a nasal spray. We also have Caleb's ear infection medicine. He should only really use this if he's been prescribed it, but he does suffer when he's swimming, so I tend to pack it just in case. And then I've also got the boys' Calpol melts. Then in my handbag day to day, I have about 4 plasters or band-aids in various sizes and 2 little wound wipes in case they graze their knees. Really important to wash it as soon as you can, and mine always do graze their knees, especially in the summer when they're wearing shorts. And the last thing that I wanted to show you is that we recently got this little crossbody bag for my son. One of them has an allergy, which means they need 2 EpiPens and an allergy medicine on them at all times. And up until this point, it's always been in my handbag, but we're very much trying to make it his responsibility now. He's getting older, and it's really important that he just always thinks to have it on him. Matt grew up with asthma, and he always needed to remember to have his pump on him. So it was his idea to get him this bag. He really likes it. It's just a Nike one, and he helped choose it. And it's nice because it fits other things in it, so he can also fit a tablet in it. So if he was going to a friend's house, he could put the things in there that he wants, but also have his medicine on him. And he's definitely getting there with remembering it. Whenever we get into the car, we're like, have you got your bag? And most of the time it's a yes, sometimes it's a no, but we're really getting somewhere. So yeah, just something to think about. If your child also has an allergy, might be worth getting them a really nice bag that they like, to remember to bring it out with them at all times. Right, so that's everything that I wanted to show you. I hope you liked this video and it wasn't too random. If there's anything else that you think is essential in a family medical kit, I would love to know about it in the comments below. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye guys. Oh, and also, I hope I haven't been sweating during this video. It is 33 degrees in the UK today, which is unheard of, and it is so hot in here. So yeah, I'm melting. I'm off to go and get in the paddling pool with the boys, but yeah, bye guys.